I request Dr. Elderson to handle the certificate of appreciation to Dr. Subramanian. And the certificate of appreciation to Dr. Gopadhyay.
Well, good evening to you all, and maybe I try to focus on the case series on the topic prevention of sudden cardiac arrest or prevention of sudden cardiac death. I'm not going to talk about cardiology part in detail. Maybe for a basic clinician, basic MBBS approach, how best we can recognize and to refer to a specialist, okay? So I'm heading cardiac arrhythmology department and arrhythmias, devices, and heart failure transplant program in near hospitals. So one patient came to the casualty. Patient came to the casualty, just collapsed. That was the ECG cardiac. Can see that. So it's basic thing. Now, most of you have ICUs, monitors, basic clinical management. Okay? So what's happening? It's broad complex tachycardia, regular broad complex. So it is ventricular tachycardia. Patient collapsed and patient DC verted. And this is the ECG after DC cardioversion. Clearly, what does it show? Inferior wall myocardial infarction. So, 2-3 AVM, ST elevation, T inversion, and you can see pauses in between. There is a block, 2:1 AV block, a blocked sinus main. Okay? So, when you see heart blocks in inferior wall myocardial, imagine that this is right coronary artery disease.
Excuse me, sir.
Sir.
You are not able to see. You are not the...
Okay. So, this is acute inferior wall MI. So, that's how patient... that's why patient arrested. So don't think all myocardial infarctions will have typical chest pain and they come to your emergency or OPD room. So 10% of cardiac acute coronary syndromes presentation is sudden cardiac arrest or sudden cardiac death. So DC verted and it's going back. Yeah, I will play because I think just click on it. Back. It's not playing because my Mac is not supporting this. At least you can appreciate the thrombus here in the right coronary artery. Okay? So it's an egg chap. It's a huge thrombus sitting in the right coronary artery. Next. It's a beautiful coronary angiogram. So that is next. That's the thrombus. Next slide. This is the thrombus suction catheter. Next. And that is the thrombus. Huge thrombus. So if you want to take the selfie with your death, that is the selfie. So that would have been killed the patient if patient has arrested outside. He's a lucky man that he got arrested. So prevention. What do you mean? So the topic is prevention of sudden particles. So remember, any acute myocardial infarction patient, hemodynamically unstable, have high chance, high potential for cardiac arrest. Okay? If he is hemodynamically unstable, please refer to a cardiologist where there is a cath facility in the primary PCA. Patient stable, immediately not affordable, and you want to save the time, then thrombolyze. Okay, next. This is post-stenting. Patient survived, back home, happy. So, and remember, after or during the myocardial infarction, watch for the ventricular ectopics. They are ventricular ectopics. And you see P, P, Q, R, S, and T, and then the ectopic. Ventricular ectopics isolated, that means if there is a drunkard opposite your house, but without disturbing you, creating no nuisance, you can bear them. But if there is a drunkard troubling your wife, children, and you with all nuisance, you cannot tolerate. And remember, in monitor, if you have an ICU, if you see ectopics, ventricular ectopics, next slide, if they happen like this, touching the neighbor, so this ectopy is almost touching the TV. That means he's disturbing you. Even it can be single ectopy, if it falls on the TV, so that triggers the VT. Next. That's how patient dies in acute myocardial infarction. Okay? The ventricular ectopics falls on the repolarization. At the same time, you cannot switch on and switch off. It will have to switch off or switch off. So heart becomes confused. One beat is contracting, and at the same side, another beat is relaxing the heart. That's how heart goes into a seizure, tachycardia, fibrillation. That's the main reason for death in acute myocardial infarction. Next. So this is known as R on T phenomenon. So the drunkard disturbing the normal neighbor. That's how people die. Next. Sometimes patients who already have cardiac infarction, heart disease, will come to see you and take an ECG. There are important clues to prevent sudden cardiac death. Look at the ECG. What do you observe? It is not acute of mine. But do you see all the normal complexes of ECG? No. See the multiple splintered, 1, 2, something, 3. They're not normal ECGs. Normal ECG is a beautiful vein, QRS. So this is something splintering. What do they suggest? Next. They suggest the scar of old myocardial infarction. If you see these bizarre multiple QRS complexes on ECG, routine ECG, think that he's going to die suddenly. Because that is a sign of scar like a ghost. That triggers ventricular tachycardia. They are at high risk of sudden cardiac death. What they require? They require an ICD implantation. Next, they may develop this at one point of time, VT. Scar is not dead scar. That was a misconception. Infarction means death. How a dead scar that dead man can kill a person, right? Please remember, until I became an electrophysiologist, even I don't know this fact. Actually, scar is not a scar. It is like an accident in a train or bus. Some die, some escape, some are injured. They will be crying. It's all not all the dead tissue. Some cells in that scar are viable. Okay? And they are ischemic. They are crying. That cry is the signature of that ECG. They showed the electricity and produced VT and sudden death. Next. Just remember, when you see a narrow complex, you see people, you know, undergraduate teaching. Narrow complex is SVT, nice. Broad is bad. Whenever you see broad complex on the surface ECG, next. Broad is always bad. Remember, it must be a ventricular tachycardia. Next. And high chance of sudden death, syncope. Next. That's what it is, these complexes. There may be subtle clues, but watch for this. Next. So what do we do? Just view. What can we do? We can map those scar potentials here with in electrophysiology lab with 3D anatomical mapping. Next. Next. And we can map and we can ablate. We can destroy. We can kill the injured cells so that they don't produce electricity. Next. So that's not allowed. Next. So sometimes they may even receive automated implantable cardiac defibrillator. Next. An young child, 32-year-old, sudden dyspnea of Monday duration. Clinical examination is normal. Class 4 dyspnea, one day, I tell you, clinical examination is normal. What is the diagnosis?
Excellent.
It is class 4 dyspnea, not acute MI. Acute MI, you have severe ST elevation pictures. Next. Typically, S1, Q3, T3. It is seen only in 10% of pulmonary embolism, but that is very specific. This young chap died because of massive pulmonary embolism. So, any good situation might have prevented this. Next. Of course, the ABC will be alkalosis. Next. D-dimer positive. Next. You see the thrombus in the pulmonary artery. Next. See, the right atrium, right ventricle is dilated compared to the left, and there is a huge thrombus sitting at the tricuspid level. Next. See the CT scan, saddle embolus, classical textbook description. We lost the patient. Next. Very important. This happened in Chennai. Patient was, I think, walking on the street, collapsed, arrested, and somebody brought him to the hospital. He was shocked, and this was the ECG. And all tests were normal. What is the diagnosis? This is what we need to know. This patient's coming to you. Why is this patient arrested? Shock. Look at the V1. It is not MI. Something in V1, V2. Only V1, V2 elevation, like a bundle branch block. And patient is otherwise normal. And these patients develop syncope is Brugada syndrome. This is a genetic cardiomyopathy. Okay? They have high chance of sudden death. The only treatment is ICD implantation. Next. Young lady with recurrent syncope. She was referred for me by another cardiologist for VT ablation. So this is VT definitely, right? Broad complex tachycardia. VT. young lady. Next, I have investigated her. This is the normal ECG. 20 times she received the shock. Next. Echocardiogram, something interesting. You see some bright spot? You see, it's not just some specialist thing, you know. Simple clues. Bright spot. And then this thing, you know, the echo machine. And cardiac MRI shows same spot is bright, including some of the myocardial enhancement. This suggests some inflammation is going on. Okay? Normal myocardial doesn't look like this. Next. And this is the node. Chest CT, mediastinum. Okay? This is what? Cardiac sarcoidosis. Okay? Cardiac sarcoidosis. So I can ablate, but the BT recurs. Recurs. So the best treatment is ICD implantation. Simple clues. Conjunctivitis, blepharitis, lymph node, bilateral hilar lymphadenopathy, erythema nodosum. They're all clinical clues. If patient has recurrent syncope, think that there is cardiac sarcoidosis. Next. She received, this is one of the first implant MRI pacemaker in India, South India especially. Next. A young man from Nigeria with recurrent syncope. This is the ECG. What could be the diagnosis? Recurrent syncope with this ECG. But it is not Down's, it is that something like hypertrophy, left bundle, something like hypertrophy. This is hypertrophic cardiomyopathy. Syncope in hypertrophic cardiomyopathy, high risk cardiomyopathy. They need pacemaker and with ICD back. Next. So this is slow VT, this is fast VT. Next. They develop ventricular tachycardia. And finally, patient received dual chamber ICD with pacemaker backup. Next. Just 2-3 more cases. Again, wide complex. Baseline, next. You see something here on surface is zero. Something splintering in V1 lead. So when you see some splintered complexes in V1, in a patient who has syncope, think of arrhythmogenic right ventricular dysplasia. And you can, so this is small clues, small simple ECG analysis, and patient receives ICD. That will only save the life. Next. So you see broad. Next. So what happens? The myocardium in heart is replaced by fat, which produces ventricular tachycardia. Next. So this is the fat replacement. Next. So one important case. Very important. This girl received a book of EEGs. 30 times, 40, every time she gets seizure, she consults a neurologist. The neurologist takes a bundle of EEGs. And nobody cares examining other man why there is recurrent seizure and EEGs are normal. This is long QT syndrome, genetic cardiomyopathy, recurrent VF, VTVF patient is having. So if you long QT ECG, it's a genetic syndrome. The only treatment is ICD to prevent cardiac death. Okay. Syncope, neurology is normal. First, cardiology should see. Syncope, neurology, please remember, has a focus, has a vascular territory, has a neurological sign. Okay? And patient just cannot syncope and walks normally. If patient recovers normally after loss of consciousness, it is not stroke. It is cardiac arrest. Next. They are all VTs in structurally normal heart. Please remember, any person who has VT, don't they suffer for coronary angiogram. And 9 chap 24 years, it will be normal. And finally, they refer for me and they are all structurally normal heart VTs. Next. Why this VT develops? Next. because of this Purkinje cell, an irritable Purkinje cell in a normal heart can produce VT and sudden death. So please remember this. So how to identify the markers of sudden cardiac arrest and death? Important clinical clues, just go to the last slide. So we can ablate, see the tachycardia gets ablated, suddenly we can cure those diseases. This is after cure, go to the last slide. So similar examples of structurally normal heart. So many cases like this. So back. So first is take a good history, examine the patient, analyze all clues, not just an ECG, okay? So ECG can be a normal, a potentially dangerous patient, whereas ECG can be scary in a normal patient, simple anemia, okay? ECG can be depressed, okay? So similar to same. Next. So sudden death is not just a phenomenon, okay? It has a design. You watch these movies, so it strikes you definitely. It has a beautiful plan to take your life away. But it gives you a chance sometimes that, okay, I give you an option, I'll come back later. So take that opportunity to cure, to prevent the death sometimes. Many a time we can really prevent sudden cardiac arrest and death. But if a patient is designed to die at the end of the life, we don't know. We cannot say. But really, most of the times, if you're a good clinician, you can identify and then bring to your specialist. Thank you.
Sir, one more question, sir.
Yes, sir.
The syncope with the normal EEG, normal, I mean, CNS structure, you at least put like a cardiac arrest. You are doing this cardiac arrest.
Because usually you will be seeing the patient after recovery, right? So it is good if somebody takes an ECG during that episode. Okay? And a simple history, usually syncope 40% cardiac, 30% neurologic, 10% others, and 25% you don't find the cause. Can be simple vasovagal unexplained syncope. So first evaluate heart, and if cardiac evaluation is normal, then send to a neurologist. And if everything is normal, finally send to a good physician, is the best person to evaluate.
I'll just add a word, I'm a neurologist. So the point is about whether it's a syncope or a seizure. Okay. A syncope, we primarily go to the cardiologist. It's about an episode of loss of consciousness. That's where the patient comes in. The point which will help, which has been noted in studies and the meta-analysis, evidence says that if there is postictal confusion, it's a seizure. If the patient says, I fell down, I woke up, I was clear of what was happening around me, it is a syncope. I go by that. The second thing that always helps is a sense of lightheadedness they have before they fall. If they have the sense of light in them, and you have to be a little careful, some seizures have that aura, some temporal lobe seizures, but they say, I had this lightheadedness, things went out of focus, I knew I was going to fall, that's probably a seizure. And it's very brief, it never lasts for a minute or two. You know, by nature, syncope, falling down is the cure for syncope. It's actually a drop in BP. So they fall down, the body re-establishes circulation to the brain, they become all right. It's actually a natural reaction. So if they say they fall down, they get better, then it definitely it's probably a syncope. So that's what we go by.
Most importantly, the best test is history. History is very important.
That's what I was wondering. I really wondered how the child survived. If you see the ECG, probably it is short runs, and probably nature gives us an opportunity still you have time to go. I really wonder why the child, she came with a, of course, she's a poor girl, poor family, one of my friend referred, she's a bunch of ECGs, and she just requires an ICD. Why the child survived, really difficult for me to answer, because several episodes of VTVF, then surviving is really, you know, she must be lucky.
Thank you. So please, now I request you, Dr. Srinivasa Varma, please come for and hand over the certificate appreciation to Dr. S. Guru Prasad.